How's it going? I'm installing an intake today. My first aftermarket part on this car.
It is a it's a DDM Works intake. Came with a K&N and
the stock intake system is really dumb. Mazda went to great lengths to try and quiet this. So the air goes in here, through the filter, all the way around, and then up in here into the throttle body, which is like right under there. Make throttle response a lot better, and it'll get that awesome induction noise that we all want. Yeah, without further ado, let's get started. All right, so I removed this. For some reason, my camera stopped recording, so I don't know. I bought a brand new SD card, but for some reason, it doesn't seem to be working. So hopefully I can film this install. So that's removed, and the next step is to do something around here. All right, so I removed this hose, and I think I need to pull up on this. Just like that, okay. All right, so this is out of the way. Now we have to remove these two, just these hose clamps. Alrighty. These stupid group chats. So now that that's out of the way, we need to remove the MAF airflow sensor, which I guess is this. All right, so I got the connector loose, and now there's two Phillips screws that I have to undo, so yes, this fits. Hopefully I can get the last one with this. Okay, that's the airflow sensor. That's pretty cool. That's kind of neat. Sweet. All right, so here's what I did. This bolt, or this screw right here, is too long. You can see the little washer I put in there. And it's not going anywhere. And then I have the K&N on here. And then I have to put the rubber coupler on here, and then I guess just slide it in to the throttle body right here. And then I think that's pretty much it. And then connect everything up, obviously. All right, so DDM says, have it oriented like this. So this is the thing, the tube goes on here, and then you want the thread up here to be like 180 degrees up. That makes sense. So this down, and then this up. I guess it's just for ease of install or whatever. All right, I'm gonna start it up, see how she sounds. Yeah, so right away I noticed a difference in the sound, which is awesome. And yeah, it's a lot more simpler. It just goes in there, because like I said in the outset, the air went in through here and there, all the way around, and then back through this tube, and then into the throttle body. I wish there was a way to remove this. There is. There's three screws to remove it, but to remove it permanently. But there's a bunch of electrical connections all in there. So if there's a way to do that, then that would be perfect. All right, so just finished my rip. I was out for a rip with a new intake, and holy shnikes, this thing is awesome. It's totally woken up the car. It's way louder. I can hear like echo off like buildings and whatnot, which is pretty sweet. Has way more presence on the road as well. Obviously, a camera won't be able to do it justice, so you can only really find this out for yourself if you buy it for your little Mazda 2. But I'm here to tell you, buy it, because it's great. One of the best bang for buck installs you can get, because it cost me like $150 US. No, sorry, $150 Canadian, $115 US, because I live in Canada, so the dollar is like super bad. But anyway, thank you very much for watching. In the next video, I'm gonna do a review along with some sound clips for you guys to give you like the full effect. And yeah, thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I will see you soon. Have a good one. Peace.